You know, as I was getting ready to come into my basement and get set up to teach class, we were just finishing up with dinner, and I was grabbing the broom. Now that we have a dog, you know, there's like dog hair everywhere. It's making me a little bit crazy, but I grabbed the broom to bring it with me, and just was like teasing my children about sweeping up, and in that moment, my daughter's water glass slipped out of her hand, and the glass crashed to the floor and broke into 1,000 pieces, and water splashed everywhere. And everyone in that moment just stopped. Like, it was one of those like shocking moments where we were all just like, crash, you know? And one of the things about those sort of startling moments, those things that happen unexpectedly, is that the yogis believed that those moments of unexpected things that surprised us or that didn't go as planned are actually moments where we really wake up and we're fully participating in this moment of unity, that we're really super present. And I absolutely felt that in the moment that happened just a little bit ago in my kitchen. You know, this idea of bringing ourselves back to the present is one of sort of the fundamental tenets of what is happening for us in a yoga practice. And sometimes we use active asana, we use movement, we use the way that we show up on our yoga mat in a physical and active way to become really present. But other times, like the practice we're doing tonight, we're going to create a kind of receptive space for ourselves, really passive participation in the shapes of the postures, so that the thing that keeps bringing us back to the moment is the breath. It's not an action in the body, it's not something active that we need to make happen, but instead the invitation is to rest as completely as possible so that the breath has this way of bringing us back to the present again and again and again. So we're participating in the breath not to control or shape or make it do anything special, but just using the breath as a tool to help call our attention back again and again and again. So this is our plan for practice tonight. We're going to build some structures with our props and then arrange our bodies in some strategic shapes and then use those strategic shapes to help us direct the breath in a way that we can call our attention back to it over and over again. It's easy to think that the goal of this work is to have our attention with the breath and for it never to wander, but that's not it at all, actually. It's a bit like my daughter breaking her glass, is that every time something changes or shifts, we get a new opportunity for the mind to come back. The yoga isn't in holding the mind steady, it's in those moments where the mind comes back again and again from its wanderings. Okay, that's the plan. I'd actually love for you to start lying down tonight. So come to lie down. You could be on your back, or if you want to be on your side, if you've got some reason that your back doesn't work for you. And you're welcome to add any props that could make this feel more comfortable, but just come to lie down on your back. It doesn't have to be fancy or special, just lie down. And let your arms land in a comfortable place. They could be by your sides. I always find that my hands land most comfortably when they're in contact with my body. You pick. It doesn't, again, have to be special or particular. But when we lie down, the muscles that hold us up, the structures that work in our bodies, don't have to work as hard anymore. And it's not only about the physical structures, but all of our internal structures, all of the systems of the body start to get this message that it's time to wind down. There's also something pretty fascinating that happens with the breath and the respiratory system. When we lie down, the breath has an easier time finding a neutral place. Close your eyes or turn your gaze downward. And start from this big expansive space of observation. Notice whatever there is to notice. Maybe there's some sounds in your home. Maybe you can hear something outside. Notice if there's a particular taste in your mouth. If you catch a scent in your nose. Notice what your eyes can see. Perhaps colors or shapes under closed eyes. Or if you have your eyes open, what is it that passes at open eyes? Notice the texture of the clothing against your skin. Feeling of the earth under your feet or your heels or whatever part of you is touching the ground. And then notice your breath. There's no right place to land your attention when it comes to the breath. Maybe you can feel the movement of air at your nostrils. Or maybe you can feel the breath under your collarbones, or moving in your ribs. Sometimes you can catch the feeling of the breath in your belly. Or in your sides. Just take a moment to notice your breath, however it's showing up for you tonight. Also worth noticing if as you've been lying here in this fairly still position, if you're able to notice other things, or maybe those things you were noticing when we first lay down are different. This practice of being really present can have a sometimes surprising transformational aspect. This is really at the heart of what we're doing in yoga. Connecting and noticing, practicing a kind of attentiveness. It's a receptive practice. Moving slowly here, roll over onto your side. Use the support of your hands and your arms and push your body up into a seated position. Keep your gaze soft as you blink open your eyes. All right, for our first pose today, we're gonna employ as many props as you can find. I'd like for you to build up a really high elevated stack for your back. So I've got two blocks, and maybe you also have two blocks, or perhaps you're gonna use pillows. If you have blocks like I do, you can set the blocks up, one on the middle side and one on the low side. You can even put yourself up higher if you'd like to have a bigger stack. And then the bolster should be arranged on an angle, or perhaps you're using some bed pillows, whatever kind of firm support you could find to support your back. You could do this without blocks, right? If you've got some cushions, you know, you could build those up under the upper half. The idea here is just to create a support for your back that lands you on an angle. You should also find something that you could use to rest your elbows. These are my handy pillows from a chair that just are exactly the right height for me to rest elbows on. It could be that you're gonna use blankets there, or maybe you have some throw pillows as well. The idea is not to let your arms dangle or drop too far towards the floor, but that your arms should also be held in the same way that your back is held. You won't need them for the first pose, but you'll need it for the second pose, something to rest your legs on, so have those nearby as well.
I happen to have some folded blankets here that I'm going to use when the time comes. And you should also grab your strap or whatever strap substitute you might be using, because we're going to use this to support our legs. It takes a little negotiating to find the just right position for your body in nearly all of these postures. I already know that I like to have an extra support under my head. Maybe you will find that that's true as well. To come into this posture, scoot back against the bolster or whatever props you're going to lean back on, and then bend your knees so your feet are flat on the floor. Wiggle your feet out far so your feet are wide, and let your knees drop in towards one another. And then here's where the strap comes in. So I don't want you to have to hold any effort at all in your legs. Use your strap or your tie or whatever prop you might be having here and loop that around your thighs so that your legs will be held up. The general direction of the movement of legs is more internal. And I mean, inseams of pant legs are kind of rolling down towards the floor. And then once you have your strap set up, not too tight, not too loose, right, it should feel supportive, and you can always adjust it as needed. Come to lie back so that your whole entire back is supported on the bolster. Aim to get your head in line with the rest of your spine. And then let your elbows drop down onto support so that your hands can rest either on the front of your thighs or on your belly, or depending on how your arms are landing, it might feel more comfortable for your shoulders just to have your forearms supported. The aim here with the arm support is that it shouldn't feel like a tug or a drag across the front of your chest. Instead, it should feel like your arms are held in the same way that your spine is held, in the same way that your legs are held. And then, of course, make any adjustments that would make this position feel more sustainable. You might find your arms have to go up higher. That's what I'm noticing about my own arms. Notice about your head, especially. One of the things that's tricky about this position is because you're in a slight back bend, the temptation is to let your head fall way back. If you can make sure that your head is supported all the way up so it doesn't feel like the front of your throat is hanging open, but instead front of throat and back of neck are open evenly. Then close your eyes or turn your gaze downward if you prefer to practice with eyes open. Go back to that practice that we started, that practice of noticing. It's as if you're taking a big wide-angled lens here. Notice whatever there is to notice. Perhaps something about the sensation of your body. Perhaps there's something to notice from your five senses. We're aiming to cultivate stillness in these postures tonight. But please know that you're never stuck. You can make an adjustment or a movement at any time. But make that movement thoughtfully and purposefully with no sense of urgency at all. Become aware of your breath now. First is just simply an opportunity to notice that you're breathing. There's nothing special to do with the breath. You're not trying to control it or manipulate it or turn it into anything. Practice just allowing the breath to go where it goes. And then start to pay particular attention to the exhalation. The inhale just come passively, receptively, almost as if mind ignores the inhale. But start to feel particularly attentive to the exhalation. Watch your exhalations as if they're some of the most fascinating things you've ever seen. Notice the sensation of the breath at your nose. Feel that kind of whole body softening that happens when you release the breath. And with each exhalation, observe the sensation of weight in your pelvis. Feel the exhale traveling down your body into the floor under your seat. Imagine that you're breathing out not through your nose, but through your hips. Expect that the mind will wander, maybe even get bored with this project of observing the breath. But every time that you catch your mind considering something else, it's an opportunity to practice yoga again, to bring your attention back, to return to the present moment. The present sensation of breath exhaling down and out. Every exhale, a chance to reconnect with the feeling of breath leaving your body. There's some moment where you realize that you've fallen asleep. You just get to wake up and start again. Observing each exhalation.
you find that your mind has wandered away, bring it back into the breath. Come back into the space of noticing. As you've probably guessed, there's no sense of urgency in this practice at all. So there's no need to rush or to move quickly to adjust any part of your position. In fact, before you move, notice how your legs feel. Notice your arms. Notice the sensation of the support behind your back. Then, going very carefully, reach towards your strap or whatever you've got holding your legs. And untie or unbuckle, remove the strap, and set it off to the side. Notice what that feels like to no longer have the strap holding your legs in place. Then, still moving with great care, position your feet so that the soles of your feet can touch, and open your knees out to the sides, the opposite of what your legs had just been doing. This time, your legs get to rotate externally. Use blankets or pillows or some other support under your legs. Try to pull yourself way back from the edge. If you just happen to be in a body that has a lot of flexibility with this movement, even you should tuck your legs in tight. It should feel as if you're drawing yourself in and cozying up in this position. If there's any other props you might need to add, maybe you've noticed that your body temperature has dropped, it's a good time to place a blanket over the center of your body. You could put your socks on. Perhaps you need to adjust the position of your head. Take this as a moment to reorganize in your pose. Just as I mentioned before, we're cultivating a sense of stillness in this posture, but it shouldn't ever feel like you're stuck. Always have permission to adjust or to change your pose, shape, anytime you need to. As you get yourself settled, take that big wide lens of noticing. Notice whatever there is to notice. New sensations in your body. Perhaps a new feeling of the breath. This time we focus more on the inhalation. We're still practicing in this very receptive, observational way. So there's no need to force or strain or fight the breath. Just get absorbed in the sensation of the inhalation here. Maybe you'll feel breath at your nose, maybe you'll feel the breath more obviously in your chest. You'll feel breath in your belly. Let the exhalations happen on their own. But pay super close attention to the feeling and the sensations of the breath moving in. Observe the inhalations as if they're the most fascinating thing you've ever seen. Feel the breath rising up as if you're breathing into your hips and up to the crown of your head. Your mind wanders away, you just get a new opportunity to practice paying attention again. The yoga is in bringing our attention back when it wanders. Slip off to sleep, no problem. You get to practice yoga when you wake back up. Notice each breath in. attention back if mind had been wandering. There's no urgency here. No need to move quickly. No need even to wrangle your mind back. But allow your mind to notice that more expansive, wide-angle view. Feel this pose in your body. To change the position that you're in, move your legs. Bring the soles of your feet onto the floor and draw your knees in towards one another. Then, still moving carefully and slowly, extend your legs out along the floor in front of you. It's a good place again to make any other little adjustments that your body might want or need. Perhaps with legs extended, you'll want to change the position of the blanket that's covering your body. Or maybe it's time to add a blanket if you hadn't had one already. It's a good place to make any adjustments to your head or to the support under your spine. Make sure that your arms continue to be well supported in this slightly different position for your legs. And as you get organized, come back to the breath. Come back to noticing everything more expansively. The feeling of your whole body in the pose. Notice if there's something to notice from your five senses. Then come back to participate in that receptive way with the breath. Bring your attention especially to the breath on the right side of your body. It's both inhale and exhale this time. But just imagine that the breath is only breathing in and out through your right nostril. Extend your right arm straight if it hadn't been out straight by your side before. Make a fist with your right hand and then lift your right arm up away from the props. This is the most active we'll get in our practice today. Put just a little bit of effort in holding your right arm. Make your arm straight, but keep your fist. It doesn't have to be a super fierce action, but enough energy and effort in the muscles of your arms and shoulder to keep your arm elevated. continue that work of noticing the breath on the right side. Perhaps even notice how the breath has shifted because of this work you're now doing in your right arm. Notice if it's more difficult to pay attention to the breath. If your mind gets caught up in the effort of holding your arm, and that kind of wondering about how long this will go on. Watch the mind's turnings. And whenever you notice the mind has lost the breath, that's your chance to come back, to participate in the present observation of the breath. Now release your arm. Relax your hand. Let your arm rest into the support of the props. Feel how different the right side of your body is. Notice how different the breath feels. Continue the work of observing. Inhale and exhale on the right side of your body. Attention back if your mind wandered off. Bring attention back to the breath and the right side of your body. that wider angled view. Now to include the left side. Is there a difference between the two sides of your body? Shift your attention now to the left side. Observe both inhale and exhale. But just as if the left side of your nostril is breathing, as if you're breathing only in and out of the left nostril. Carefully, make a fist with your left hand. Lift your left arm up away from your props. Make your arm straight, but only apply enough effort to keep your arm elevated as if it's floating above the things that it was resting on. Notice how lifting your left arm changes your breath. Notice how lifting your left arm makes your mind do different things. Sometimes it's easier to feel the breath on the left side when you've created effort here. Other times, you might notice that your mind gets caught up in thinking about what's happening, wondering how long the arm has to be elevated, perhaps caught up in the sensation and the energy or the effort of keeping arm up. Each time that you find your mind spins away from the breath, you get a chance to bring your mind back to the breath on the left side. Release your left arm now. Let it rest down into the support of the props. Release your left fist. And notice how the breath changes. Just breathe on the left side. Inhale. Exhale on the left. back to your breath. Take that broader view and notice whatever there is to notice. Still no urgency to move. Notice all the parts of your body first. Then, moving slowly, bend your knees one at a time and plant the soles of your feet onto the floor. Bend your elbows one at a time and bring your hands in close towards your body. Then shift your hips slowly, roll over onto your side, either partially supported or roll all the way down onto the floor next to your bolster. Drop your chin in towards your chest. Imagine here curling in around your heart. Then using the support of your hands and your arms, carefully guide your body into a seated position. Close your eyes or turn your gaze downward as you get into your seat. Feel the impact of those poses. A full deep breath in, whole body, both nostrils. Pause at the top of the inhalation for just a beat and exhale completely through your mouth. Keep your gaze soft. A blink. Open your eyes. Take your props away from your mat. Make an arrangement for your body where you can lie down on your back. Keep whatever props might make you feel comfortable. If you need support for under your knees, you're welcome to arrange your bolster under your knees. Perhaps you'd like a cushion or a small pillow for under your head. Make sure that you'll be warm enough, a blanket for over your body. If it's possible that you have a little extra weight somewhere nearby, maybe it would be your bolster or a pillow or even just a folded blanket, have that ready to place at the top of your thighs or across your low belly. You're welcome to arrange your legs however you like. It could be that you'd like to go back to having your knees rest against one another in that more internal rotation. It might be that you preferred the external rotation with knees dropping out to the sides. Or maybe in this position on your back, you'll go to legs out straight. Take your extra weight with your bolster or your blanket and place that extra weight across the tops of your thighs and low belly. If for whatever reason that extra weight does not feel nice for your body, it's not required. Make any adjustments again, so that you can find a comfortable and organized place for your body to land.
let your arms rest down by your sides. And then make a fist with both hands. Lift both arms up away from the floor. Only apply enough effort as is required to keep your arms elevated. Not a lot, but just a little bit away from the floor or your props. Notice the way that your breath changes. The way your breath responds to the effort of holding your arms in place. Notice the way your mind responds. Your mind jumps in to analyze the movement or the effort. Maybe your mind tries to escape the work of this pose by thinking of other things. Allow yourself to be curious about the mind's engagement here. Continue to use the breath to bring you back more present to whatever's unfolding. Now release both arms. Relax your fists. Notice the change in your breath. Allow your mind to rest with the sensations of inhale and exhale. Breathe in and out through both sides of your nostrils. Notice the inhale rising up to chest and head, and the exhale settling you back down into hips and legs. When the mind wanders, it becomes a new chance to practice yoga by bringing attention back. Slip off to sleep. Whenever you wake up, you get a new chance to start noticing again. attention back. If you find that your mind has wandered off, notice whatever there is to notice. Take that wide view. Feel whatever there is to feel in your body. Notice anything about the sensations, the information you receive from your senses. Take a more purposeful breath in through both nostrils. Pause at the top of the inhalation. Exhale completely through your mouth. We still have no sense of urgency to move or adjust. Before you do, notice if there's some part of your body that feels particularly keen to move or be moved. However it might feel nice for you to adjust, do that now. It might look like bending knees to put your feet flat to the floor. It might look like reorganizing your pelvis so that your low back makes contact with the mat. Perhaps your arms would like to pull in closer to your body. Make any movements or adjustments that feel settling, that respond to what body wants or needs in this moment. As you're feeling ready, remove the blanket from your belly and thighs, or whatever you were using to weight yourself there. Roll over onto your side. Tuck your chin in and pull your knees in. Curl in around your heart. Use the support of your hands, your arms.
Push your body back up into your seated position. Close your eyes or turn your gaze downward. Rejoin your palms together in front of your heart. A wish for peace for all beings everywhere. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti Om. Peace, peace.